In this example, we're going to practice using the shell method for rotations around the y-axis. So here are the directions. Let R be the region bounded by y equals sine of x squared and the x-axis between x equals 0 and x equals the square root of pi over 2. Use the shell method to set up an integral for the volume of the solid generated when R is revolved around the y-axis. Well, it's always a good first step to start by sketching a graph of your region R. So let's start with that. All right, so here I have plotted the graph of y equals sine of x squared. Of course, the x-axis is just right here. And then we're looking at between x equals 0, so over here, and x equals square root of pi over 2, which is approximately 1.25, so right about here. And this is my region R. So what's happening is that I am revolving this region around the y-axis. And I'm using the shell method. And what that means is I'm going to be thinking about slicing this region into pieces that are parallel to my axis of rotation. So in this case, then parallel to the y-axis. Okay, so as our next step, I'm going to write down just the general formula for the shell method around the y-axis. And that looks like this. V equals the integral from A to B of 2 pi R of x, H of x, dx. Okay, so a few things to note about this formula. First of all, it's important to realize that we're integrating with respect to x here. So when you use the shell method, you're going to be integrating with respect to x when you revolve around the y-axis or any other vertical line. So another thing to note is the way I've written this, 2 pi r of x, h of x, is kind of a conceptual way of thinking about the formula. So in here, r of x represents the radius of a shell, or another way to think about it is the distance between the axis of rotation and a slice. So on my picture then, I've drawn in blue here a example slice of this region. So then R is the distance between my axis of rotation, which is the y-axis, and my slice. Okay, so this is R. And it should be a function of x here, since I'm integrating with respect to x. Okay, so what do we think that's going to be? Well, it's actually just going to be x, right? The distance between the y-axis here and my slice is simply some distance x along the x-axis, right? And that's going to be different for every slice, which is fine. We'll integrate over an interval of x values. Okay, so this r of x equals x. So then what does h of x stand for? Okay, so h of x stands for the height of a shell. Or maybe a better way to think about it, or a different way to think about it, would be the height of a slice of my region. Now, that's usually just going to be when we're dealing with vertical slices here, that's going to be top minus bottom. Okay, so in my picture here, I'm just looking for an expression that's going to give me the height of that slice. Okay, so in this case, the height is just going to be given by the function value, sine of x squared. So now I'll just put all this information together. We'll come back to the bounds in just a second, but I've got 2 pi. Well, we said the radius was x, and then we said the height of a shell or of a slice was sine of x squared. Dx. So let's just fill in the bounds. We're told explicitly the x values that bound our region. We got 0 on the left, and then the square root of pi over 2. So just remember that when you're integrating with respect to x, you have to use x values as your bounds. Now our instructions here are just to set up an integral. So this here is going to be our answer. If we were to evaluate this, we would get some numeric value, and that would be the volume of the solid created by this revolution.